Hello viewers, I'm your host Pratiksha Mishra with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin the show. India, the world's fifth largest economy with a burgeoning population exceeding 1.4 billion, stands as a pivotal player in global politics and economics. Recently, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi embarked on a significant diplomatic mission to Russia and Austria. His visit aimed at bolstering bilateral relations while addressing pressing global issues. In a bid to foster peace and development, Prime Minister Modi voiced his concerns over escalating conflicts and underscored the importance of international cooperation. Here's our detailed report.
India and Russia share a robust and time-tested friendship rooted in mutual respect and strategic cooperation. This was clearly depicted during Prime Minister Narendra Modi's recent visit to Moscow, where he was awarded the Order of St. Andrew the Apostle, Russia's highest civilian honor, by President Vladimir Putin. This award recognizes Prime Minister Modi's exceptional contributions to strengthening the strategic partnership between Moscow and New Delhi. The two nations also signed 9 MOUs spanning trade, climate and research, paving the way for innovative collaborations. PM Modi's visit underscores the pivotal importance of the India-Russia alliance, particularly in the realms of energy security and defense cooperation, highlighting a new era of strengthened ties and mutual growth.
आज की चर्चाओं में भी हमने सभी क्षेत्रों में आपसी सहयोग को मजबूत करने के लिए नए और महत्वपूर्ण निर्णय लिए हैं। हमारे संबंध केवल दोनों देशों के लिए ही नहीं, पूरे विश्व के लिए भी अत्यंत महत्वपूर्ण है।
Russia and India have deepened their energy cooperation as a key aspect of their special privileged strategic partnership. Russia fulfills India's energy requirements primarily through crude oil and natural gas imports, crucial for India's energy security. This relationship goes beyond transactions, emphasizing strategic collaboration. Both nations have partnered on multiple energy projects and continue to foster further cooperation.
The relations between India and Russia are good and important for both. Not only for India, not only for Russia, but for both. And in the context in which Russia finds itself, closer relations with India is important for Russia. India has decided to keep its friendship with Russia and at the same time, mark my words, advocate dialogue and cessation of hostilities.
Prime Minister Modi's visit to Austria coincided with the 75th anniversary of diplomatic relations between the two countries. During their meeting, the leaders discussed bilateral and global issues of mutual interest, focusing on environmental sustainability and initiatives to combat global warming. Addressing the Indian diaspora, Prime Minister Modi highlighted India's role and contributions to world peace.
हम सीना तान करके दुनिया को कह सकते हैं, हिंदुस्तान ने युद्ध नहीं बुद्ध दिए हैं। जब मैं बुद्ध की बात करता हूं तो इसका मतलब है कि भारत ने हमेशा पीस और प्रॉस्पेरिटी ही दी है। इसलिए 21वीं सदी की दुनिया में भी भारत अपनी इस भूमिका को सशक्त करने वाला है। आज जब दुनिया भारत को विश्व बंधु के रूप में देखती है तो ये हमारे लिए गर्व की बात है।
Prime Minister Narendra Modi's recent diplomatic successes in Russia and Austria underscore India's growing prominence in global diplomacy. Receiving Russia's highest civilian honor and following it with a historic visit to Austria highlight the deepening strategic partnerships and bilateral cooperation. These visits not only strengthen India's diplomatic influence but also reaffirm its dedication to promoting peace, prosperity, and collaborative solutions on the global stage.
Representatives of local bodies in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir this past week held protests in the region demanding release of development funds promised months ago. They alleged that the government led by Chaudhry Anwar ul Haq is not at all serious over making the local bodies operational in the region. Our report. The councillors of local bodies in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir this past weekend set up protest camps in the region as they voiced their anger over the lack of development funds and powers promised to them by the Prime Minister of POJK, Chaudhry Anwar ul Haq. Reflecting a growing discontent among the elected officials, the sit-in was also joined by the women councillors from across the region. They lament that the funds for their local bodies were supposed to be allocated to them more than 20 months ago, following local body elections held in November 2022. The elected representatives are expressing frustration over the lack of action and broken promises. They emphasize that local issues such as infrastructure and public services fall within their remit, not the responsibilities of higher level government officials.
तकरीबन पौने दो साल होने को हैं बलदियाती इलेक्शन हुए उससे पहले तय पाया गया कि फंड्स जो हैं बलदियाती नुमाइंदे जो हैं होंगे उन्हें दिए जाएंगे लेकिन उसके बाद की सूरत हाल आप सब लोगों के सामने है क्या वजीरों एमएलएस का हक है कि ये मोहल्ले में टूटियाँ नलके सेवरेज लाइन्स ये सारी देनी उनका काम है हरगिज नहीं ये जो बलदियाती नुमाइंदे मुंतखब होके आए हैं ये उनका काम है ये वो लोग हैं जिनके दरवाज़ों पे आसानी से सब लोग आ रहे हैं और अपनी फरियादें अपने मसाइल अपने मसले बता रहे हैं और हम लोग जानते हैं कि मोहल्ले में किसको क्या मसला है और हम लोग उसको बेहतर तरीके से हल भी कर सकते हैं.
The protesting representatives have demanded immediate allocation of funds and the power to execute their responsibilities effectively. They criticize the government for delaying the promised support and allege that the government led by Chaudhry Anwar ul Haq is not at all serious over making the local bodies operational in the region.
Wazirazam sahab, aap se aapki puri cabinet se ye sawal karta hu jis tarah aap vote lekar असेंबली में बैठे ये बात अलग है कि आपने कुछ ज्यादा वोट लिए हैं हमने कुछ कम वोट लिए आप भी जमहूरी नुमाइंदे हैं हम भी जमहूरी नुमाइंदे हैं आप भी अवाम के हकूक के महफूज हैं हम भी अवाम के हकूक के महफूज हैं मेरा आपसे ये सवाल है जब आप अपने हक का मुतालबा करते हैं तो आपको परेशानी क्या होती है हमारा वजीर आजम सेनेट असेंबली में खड़े होकर ये कहता है अगर बलदियाती नुमाइंदों को हक दिया जाए तो क्या हम रेहड़ी लगा रहे आपके सोच को सलाम करता हूं कि वजीर आजम होकर वजीर आजम के मनसब पे बैठकर आपने ये बात की मुझे अफसोस होता है हम आपसे भीख नहीं मांग रहे हम अपने हकूक की बात कर रहे हम अवाम के हकूक की बात कर रहे हम अवाम के फलाह बहबूद की बात कर रहे
Lambasting the government over their treatment of local bodies, the protesters say their demands are not just for personal gain but for the benefit of the public. They are seeking the resources necessary to address the needs of their communities effectively. People in the region have been waiting for years for a better administration that could work for their welfare and the region's development. But the apathetic attitude of the government has worsened the condition. Time now for Asia This Week, the stories from across the continent.
Pushpa Kamal Dahal expressed sadness over the disasters and instructed government agencies to conduct effective search and rescue operations. Samsung Electronics unveiled its latest foldable smartphones on Wednesday. It's bolstering AI functions in a bid to challenge Apple's dominance in the premium market. With a starting price of around $1,900, the Galaxy Z Fold 6 is Samsung's lightest and slimmest phone yet. The world's largest smartphone maker pioneered the foldable segment in 2019. The launch is crucial as competitors are surging into the market. Samsung is also offering new AI functions, including a listening mode that provides to provide people a respite from the heat after warnings go out.
実際にまあまだ梅雨が明けてないとはいえ、もう猛暑35度超える猛暑の中、すごい暑い、今年の方が去年よりも暑いのかなという感じを受けております。
Authorities in Japan had warned against the risk of heat stroke in Tokyo and areas in its east and west and urged people to avoid physical activity, while local media reports said scores of people have been hospitalized, with some dying from heat stroke symptoms over the past few days.
Moving on. India recently hosted a significant diplomatic event in New Delhi as it convened the BIMSTEC Foreign Ministers Retreat. This gathering brought together top diplomats from member countries of the Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation. The retreat marked a crucial moment for setting ambitious cooperation goals among nations sharing the Bay of Bengal, reflecting India's commitment to fostering regional unity and progress.
India hosted a retreat for Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation Foreign Ministers, during which External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar encouraged his counterparts to adopt ambitious objectives. Jaishankar engaged in several meetings during the event alongside foreign ministers and senior officials from BIMSTEC countries such as Thailand, Bangladesh, Nepal, and Bhutan. He underscored the significance of demonstrating a firm commitment to rejuvenating cooperation among the nations involved.
For India, BIMSTEC represents the intersection of the neighborhood first outlook, the Act East policy, and the Sagar vision. Each of these endeavors is being purposed with a specific focus on the Bay of Bengal. Our message should be clear that we are all determined to infuse new energies, new resources, and a new commitment into cooperation among Bay of Bengal nations.
The retreat is a platform for exchanging ideas and fostering deeper cooperation across various domains, including connectivity, trade, health, and digital infrastructure. S. Jaishankar invited suggestions from representatives of BIMSTEC member countries on how to take BIMSTEC forward. Indramani Pandey, the Secretary General of BIMSTEC who participated in the event, stated that his primary focus as Secretary General is to ensure effective implementation of decisions made by member states.
My priority as Secretary General is to make sure that the decisions taken by the member states are implemented well. It's member states who decide the priority areas for cooperation, and there are already seven sectors of priority which member states have decided, including the very important security sector, which includes different dimensions of security. So from transnational crime, terrorism to maritime security, and there are different mechanisms already on place.
This is the first time the ministers met since the BIMSTEC Charter came into effect in May 2024, which lays down principles and vision for the bloc. The inaugural edition of the meet was held in Bangkok in a similar format in July 2023. BIMSTEC is a regional grouping comprising India, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, Thailand, Bhutan, and Nepal that was established in 1997. The grouping accounts for 22% of the global population and has a combined gross domestic product of $2.5 trillion.
India, with its coastline bordering three sites, plays a pivotal role in its economy. However, rising ocean pollution poses a significant challenge. Yet, amidst this, there's a remarkable individual like Aradhana, a 10-year-old girl making a notable impact in ocean cleanup. Her young age underscores a powerful message to the global community. Take a look.
The girl diving into the ocean with a heavy oxygen cylinder is not engaging in water sports, but collecting trash from below the surface. This 10-year-old Taragai Aradhana from Karapakkam in Tamil Nadu is a role model for her efforts in ocean cleanliness. Inspired by her father, S.B. Aravind, a professional scuba diver, Taragai has been diving and cleaning the Nilgiri Ocean daily since she was 5. Aravind, with 20 years of experience, has collected about 10,000 kilograms of trash and aims to raise awareness about ocean pollution.
I'm not saying only I'm doing this job. So many marine biologists and so many scuba divers are doing the same kind of job all over the world. But it's not enough. If we want to save, see that the mistake what we've done these many years, we can't correct it in one single day or one single month or a single year. The amount of plastics what we dumped in the ocean is unbelievable. So I don't think so it will happen very soon. It's a very long process. So that is the reason I'm engaging my daughter, focusing on next generation to understand how important is the environment, saving the environmental and saving the marine life.
Following in her father's footsteps, Taragai has already collected more than 1,000 kilograms of trash by diving deep into the ocean every day. Under her father's guidance, she set a record by swimming 18 kilometers from Kovalam to Nilgiri as part of the Save the Ocean campaign.
We are using plastic and throw it in the streets. On the time of rainfalls, all the plastic mixed up in the ocean by lakes and ponds. So people have to be more aware and avoid throwing plastics to save our environment and earth.
The father-daughter duo has given a new direction to the ocean cleaning campaign. Their small contribution is raising great awareness about ocean cleanliness among people. The waste generated from increasing urbanization and industrialization in the country often flows directly into the rivers through drains, significantly polluting them. This contaminated river water eventually makes its way to the ocean, further exacerbating marine pollution. To combat this issue, sewage treatment plants are being established nationwide to treat wastewater from drains, thereby reducing river pollution. In addition to these initiatives, large-scale campaigns are being conducted to clean coastal areas and raise public awareness about the importance of ocean cleanliness. These efforts are crucial for protecting marine life and preserving the environment.
Aradhna's inspiring initiative highlights the crucial role of individual action in addressing global challenges. And with that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.